contract, and we will then monitor our infections afterwards. And all 3 weeks, again, we have done. We now have got 3 councils that will see this decision through, so that when we next meet, we will no doubt have a bevy of congratulations from constituents saying rubbish that was thought never to be moved has now been moved. Alright?
I mean, yeah, I'm happy. I think it is just worth reiterating. I'm certainly getting from none of my constituents positive messages that the new monthly regime is improving the area. Which is, we shouldn't be complacent, but we are getting the buy-in there.
So that if there is evidence that we can actually claw back some of the costs of this, it's £75 a charge.
Yeah.
Quickfair, we do precisely that. So we wonderfully educate their minds. It's a costly process. It's very much an appropriate. Alan?
Just a quickie, really. And it follows on from the whole business of enforcement and prosecution. And it's something that came up in our car park review. We have enforcement teams that either employed by the council or we employ that do a lot of enforcement to do with what we've heard about tonight, dumping cars parked illegally and also to do with dog fouling. Is there a scope, and it really goes to Joe possibly, as part of the future council, is the scope to bring those services together? We were told on this car park review that they were, they had to be kept separate, but to me, if we really want a flexible council, there must be an opportunity there, and then we can use those teams at different times, although we want to concentrate on a particular campaign.
Have a call to the
yes.
Having your dog poo and us,
yes,
seeing your dog poo, why not?
Yeah. That would be a real revolution,
wouldn't it?
By public service. I'm all for it, that's how you run your own house.
Exactly.
Yeah. All right, very good. Any other business? Yes? Very good.
Yeah.
Alright, one last point, then we close the meeting.
Yeah, I'm involved with the new report business, which you tell me a bit in that area, and concerns have been raised by a number of people at our meetings about the density of support for living accommodation in the Birkenhead area. One of our members here worked on some statistics around that, and has identified just within the sort of boundaries of Bridge Street, Chester Street, Argyle Street, 165 support accommodation beds, and that doesn't count people leaving local authority care and people at all there. We believe that the council actually said quite publicly visited Blackburn at one point, whether it was about this issue, but Blackburn adopted a policy around it. Blackburn Council have adopted a policy around this to deal with it, because the density of support accommodation lends itself to social problems, and it's a big issue for people who are attending my residence group. I don't know if that's mirrored elsewhere.
Can I ask Dawn, would you actually attend one of the residences and report back to us?
Yeah.
Alright?
There is a real in planning as well. Fit into the planning.
Alright, very good. Thank you all very much for your attendance. Can I thank the officers?